Hello people, this is Kerry Anderson. Hope you all doing well. In today's video, I'll be talking about the effect of exercise on diabetes. So if you like the video related to my health, my way, I would like to request you all please to subscribe to the channel, hit the bell icon and give thumbs up so that I will come up with more and more videos with lots and lots of information. So here we begin. Let's go. The effect of exercise on diabetes. Exercising is one of the best ways to keep your body healthy, especially if you have diabetes. Whether done regularly, exercise will help you better control and manage your diabetes, which reduces your chances of developing long-term complications. This is because when you exercise, your body consumes more oxygen and your muscles use glycogen, triglycerides and free fatty acids for energy. For your body to continue functioning properly during heightened bouts of exercise, your blood sugar level becomes stable and start to naturally decrease. After exercising, your blood sugar level drops and you reap the benefit for hours at the very basic level. Exercising reduces the amount of insulin your body needs to process carbohydrate. In this video, we will discuss the effect that exercise has on both type 1 and type 2 diabetes. Now, how does exercise affect insulin? When you start exercising, your insulin sensitivity is increased. The second one, this allows your muscle to use during and after exercising. The lasting effect that this has on your insulin level and blood sugar will depend primarily on the intensity of your workout, along with how long you are active. In some cases, exercising can help lower your blood sugar for up to 24 hours or more after workout. This is why daily exercise is so highly recommended for people with diabetes. However, everyone is different. Use your blood glucose meter to test your blood sugar before and after exercise to help you understand how it affects you. Knowing your body is critical in managing your blood glucose levels over time. Talk to your doctor if you have any questions or before starting a new exercise program. Now it comes to hypoglycemia. Another reason you need to check your blood glucose level prior to exercising is to ensure that you don't go into hypoglycemia. Hypoglycemia is when your blood sugar becomes dangerously low. It's likely to occur in people with that take insulin or an insulin secret. People who skip meals, people who exercise for long periods of time, and people who exercise too strenuously. If your blood sugar is low, below 100 mg, avoid exercising until it's at a more stable level. If you feel hypoglycemic, check your blood sugar and have 15 to 20 grams of carbohydrate. If your reading is 100 mg or lower, then check your blood sugar again and again after 15 minutes. Every 15 minutes, if it's still low, have another 15 grams of carbohydrates and wait. Repeat this every 15 minutes until your blood sugar reaches at least 100 mg. Talk to your doctor if you experience hypoglycemia to find a treatment plan that works for you. Now, exercise and diabetes. If you have type 1 diabetes, your pancreas produces little to no insulin, making blood glucose management more difficult. If you have type 2 diabetes, it means that there is an excess amount of glucose in your blood. This happens either because your body does not produce enough insulin to produce the glucose or because your body is more resistant to insulin. Regardless, exercising with diabetes will help your body lower the overall amount of glucose in your blood without added insulin. This is because your muscle use glucose directly during exercise. Exercise also makes your insulin more effective, so your cells are more readily available to use glucose. If you have either type 1 or type 2 diabetes, exercise will help you avoid long-term complications. Most importantly, exercising helps reduce the possibility of developing heart problems. Always talk to your doctor before starting a new exercise regime, or if you have any questions about what your body can and can't handle. Benefits of exercise and physical activity. In addition to the impact exercise has on your ability to manage blood glucose level, there are a number of traditional health benefits, some of which include low blood pressure, increased level of good cholesterol, weight control, more lean muscle, increased strength, stronger bones, more energy, better sleep, stress management, improved mood. Fitness recommendations for people with diabetes. If you are not currently exercising regularly, make sure that you talk to your doctor before starting any new regime. Doing so will help ensure that you pick the best exercise plan for your health. Expect to get a full physical if you're in and idyll and talk to your doctor about any diabetes related complication you have experienced over your life. This will help you find something that works for you, is safe, and will help your body build up strength. Aerobic activity. As a rule, aim for at least 30 minutes of aerobic exercise on most days of the week. Four start small and add a few minutes each day until you can continually exercise for 30 minutes. Once you hit 30 minutes, slowly start to increase your time to help your body adapt and better manage your diabetes. Some great aerobic exercises include walking, running, swimming, and playing tennis, biking, and hiking. You should also start making small changes like taking the stairs instead of the elevator to help reduce your overall sedentary behavior. If you need some motivation, check out the group classes at your nearest fitness center or studio. Strength training. After you have successfully built up your aerobic activity, add in some strength training. Strength training is beneficial to everyone and helps strengthen your muscles, joints, and even bones. For burning fat and building muscle is a great way to gain better control of your blood glucose level if you have type 2 diabetes, as muscle use more glucose than fat. Start by doing exercise using your body weight, such as squats, plank, push-ups, weight, and sit-ups. From there, you can move on to weight. If you are unfamiliar with weightlifting, hire a trainer to show you what to do. Proper form is essential to avoiding injury and getting the most out of your exercise. Aim for about 20-30 minutes of strength training 2-3 times a week, both before and after aerobic exercise. And strength training is important to take the time to stretch. Doing so beforehand will help prime your muscles and joints to work effectively, and doing so after help reduces soreness and relax your muscles. Strength or stretching is one of the best ways to prevent excess strain or injury during your workout. Stepping back from the gym. Some people love going to the gym, others absolutely hate it. Regardless of your situation, it's possible to live an active lifestyle. You don't need to spend hundreds of dollars on gym membership to stay fit. There are plenty of free online resources that you can use in the comfort of your own home. Check out one of the many free online yoga classes or workout videos. If you are an Amazon Prime member, there are a number of exclusive fitness videos at varying levels of intensity and time. So that's all about the diabetes in this video. I hope you all liked it. So before signing off, I would like to request you all, please do like, share, subscribe this video with your loved one so that they will get to know better. So this is Kerry Anderson signing off. We will definitely meet in the next video with my another content. Till then, God bless you. Bye-bye and take care.